gonna make croissants, but the real one, not those bread dough likes that you buy at your deli. We're gonna make the flaky, crispy croissant. And the procedure to make it, it's very similar to puff pastry, but the difference is, when we make croissants, we have to start by a bread dough, which takes yeast on the dough. And when we make puff pastry, we don't need yeast. The puff pastry rises by something called mechanical leavening, which is basically the layers with butter will rise it without anything else. And on the croissant, it's both by mechanical leavening and also yeast. That's the difference between those two. And let's think on croissant something like, if you had 1,000 friends to hug you, that's how your croissant will be like, with 1,000 layers. We're gonna start by the bread dough, and we are gonna activate our yeast with warm water. It's not hot water or boiling water, otherwise you're gonna kill your yeast. It's just very warm water with 1 cup of flour, only 1 cup in the beginning, with our yeast and warm water, and stir it just until your flour has no lumps. That's it, and let it rise for 20 to 30 minutes. You're gonna activate your yeast, and then you can add the rest of your ingredients. Now that this mixture has risen, we are gonna add the rest of the flour, heavy cream, and salt. Essa é amarela daquele
verão. Mix everything until well combined, and then time to put your hands on. Knead this dough for approximately 1 minute. We don't want to overdevelop the gluten at this stage. If your dough is too dry, add a little bit more of heavy cream. If it's too soft and sticky, add a little bit more of flour. After 1 minute of kneading, cover and let it sit for 20 minutes. After 20 minutes, it's time for the real kneading. You can knead with your hands for approximately 15 minutes until very well elastic and nice, or you can do with your KitchenAid for approximately 10 minutes. This is the texture and elasticity that we are looking for. Cover with plastic wrap and let it rest for 20 minutes in your refrigerator.
Now we have to make the bourrage. And the bourrage is when you shape the butter into a square. And this is very important because everything will be very geometric in this process. You have to keep everything square shape and then rectangle shape. Square shape, rectangle shape, like an infinite loop.
Place our butter between layers of plastic wrap. We need this butter to become a unit, so the less cuts you make in the butter, the better. Smash your butter with a rolling pin until you start to get a square shape by 8 by 8 inches, approximately. Always working with your hands or with the rolling pin to keep it as square as you can. It's not a home to me. First you beat it, then you can roll it. If you hide away, I'm gonna find. After you reach the 8 by 8 inches or 20 centimeters square, you're good to go. We need a cool environment and a cool counter to make croissants, because butter is a fat that is very easy to melt. If your kitchen's not too hot, reserve your butter square in your countertop until ready to incorporate in the dough. Take your dough from your refrigerator and make it a square shape the same size as your butter, 8 by 8 inches. Sprinkle some flour on your surface and let's start working on this dough. Make it a cross on the middle and turn the X facing to you. Lightly sprinkle some flour on your work surface. We don't want to dry this dough. Now with the X facing you, we are gonna open like a 4-petal thing in this dough. Always leaving a little bit of extra dough in the middle, like a little lump. That's exactly where we are gonna place our bourrage afterwards. Because of the gluten we developed from the protein that contains in the flour, this dough keeps shrinking as we roll it. But as you roll it, it's gonna expand more and more, and we are gonna reach the right thickness eventually. I wanna wait till the feelings rise. The desirable thickness we want here is about a half centimeter or 0.1 inches. We are gonna place our brush or our spanked butter on the middle of this, right where you saved that lump when we were open the dough with the rolling pin. And we are gonna place this square right on the center and close it like a letter. Bring the edges of your dough to match the edges of your butter. Don't do what I just did here. You can do better. Yeah, now I'm doing the right thing. You have to bring all the way to the edges to keep the whole thing as uniform as you can, so the butter can be distributed uniformly when you start rolling it. In order to form the layers properly, your work surface must be dusted with enough flour. We have to roll this dough out into a 9 by 18 inches rectangle. Always start by beating the dough like this to have the right width, and then you can roll out. Very carefully and slowly, we have to keep in mind that we want to spread the butter that's inside this dough, so we have to be gentle. Don't ever let this stick to your rolling pin or your surface, or you're gonna destroy your layers. These layers will be like paper thin, you have to be very careful, always keeping as geometrical as you can. We just made the first turn, so now we're gonna refrigerate this. You have to brush all the excess flour and fold this into thirds, always maintaining as a square shape as possible. If your kitchen gets too hot and your butter melts, this dough will become unworkable. It's gonna be very hard for you to work with it. If it happens, put it in your refrigerator right away. This is a sign that my butter was melting. I'm glad I was done with the first turn. Make sure you brush all the excess flour, wrap in plastic wrap, and leave in your refrigerator for an hour to harden it so we can make another turn. We are gonna make 4 turns total. So this was the first turn. We always leave the dough at the refrigerator after each turn, and we leave there for at least an hour. After an hour, unwrap your dough, and it's gonna be quite hard now to start working with it. So don't forget to beat the width and then start rolling out the lengthwise. Always the same size, 9 by 17 inches rectangle. I've done this process 3 times before, and this is my 4th and final turn. By now this dough should probably have over 3000 layers. Maybe more, maybe less. Now cut this rectangle in half, and try not to go back and forth with your knife. Try to make it all in one cut. This way the edges can rise evenly when baked. Trim all the excess weirdness on the edges, because we want to keep a nice rectangle shape here as well. Time to start cutting the triangles. That's how we make croissants from a triangle. This recipe is all very geometrical. Whoa, I wish I had those geometrical tattoos on my body. You know, those people who make squares and rectangles and triangles, it would match, but I don't. Now work with one triangle at a time. Make a little cut and roll it very tight all the way to the end. Make sure no air enters it, just roll it tight. La, 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 la. Point the two ends to face each other and look at each other forever, until you eat it, of course. Keep doing the same thing with all the triangles you have. Sua vida na cadeia do pensamento que de um momento pro outro. croissants in a baking pan over parchment paper.
Now you have been given your croissant the right shape, triangle and roll, it's time to let it proof and rise, double its size. So you have three options to do that. First option, you can leave it a warm place to double its size. It's always going to double its size, but the first option is double its size at a warm place, not warmer than 85 Fahrenheit. Leave it for 1 hour. Second option, you're gonna leave at a relatively cool place, 70 to 75 Fahrenheit for 3 hours. Or the third option, and the best one for me, that's the one I'm using, is leave at your refrigerator for 12 hours. I know, you have to have lots of patience, you wanna eat your croissant super fast because it's gonna be amazingly good, but the thing is, if you leave at your refrigerator, it's gonna develop a better flavor because it's gonna rise very, very slowly and is lower than the other options, so it's gonna develop a better flavor. That's the option I'm going for. You decide which one you want to go for. And don't forget, before you bake it, you have to bring it to room temperature. And if your refrigerator is too cold, it won't double its size. So if it doesn't double its size, bring it to room temperature and wait it till it double its size so you can bake it.
After you left it proof and rise in your refrigerator, if it was your option, remove the plastic wrap you had on top and bring it to room temperature for an hour before you bake it. For the egg wash, to give that nice shiny look in your croissant, it's just an egg with 2 tablespoons of milk and whisk it. Brush this egg wash on each croissant just like this. I lost the footage where I brushed the croissants. Bake it at 375 Fahrenheit until golden brown. Approximately 30 minutes.
My delicious real croissant, not the one you get at the corner deli. I'm sorry, but that one isn't real. No, I'm just kidding. That one is like bread. This one is flaky and real, like thousands of layers. And this is the result. I'm gonna eat the tiny one that I made because I wanna keep the big ones for the pictures. So you can eat with jam or you can eat with Gruyere cheese. You can actually make them with Gruyere and ham. When you're rolling them, you just put whatever cheese you want on the middle and then roll the triangle with the cheese. It's gonna taste delicious. Chocolate, put chocolate, roll it with chocolate. Just be super creative, like I always say. Mmm, the pure smell of butter. Listen to the noise of the flakiness and crispiness. This is my croissant recipe, super flaky and crispy. I hope you like it and see you next week with another delicious recipe. Bling! She covered their houses with mirrors to reflect the sun.